And Plus TV Africa correspondent Mary Chinda, who monitored the situation, joins us in the studio. And Dotun Hassan, who is a legal practitioner. And also, for the case, the purpose of this report, he is also the Oluomo of Abule Ado. Good morning, Dotun. Good morning, Mary. All right, we'll begin with you, Mary. It's over 72 hours that this has happened. We don't know what sort of explosion it is. We had a government official who came into the studio, and even when we said it was a gas explosion, he said it wasn't a gas explosion. Away from that story, you were there. What are the people saying? What is the mood like when you were there?
Well, it's 5 days right now after the explosion that happened on Sunday, and the last few days has been full of tears and mourning and people, you know, trying to, you know, recount their losses, especially their loved ones. Needful to say that in this loss was a couple who had just wedded in December, and both husband and wife had actually passed on, you know, in the cause of the explosion. While I was there, according to the report, we had three other bodies, including the cook of the school, that's the Bethlehem Girls School, who was actually serving the Reverend Father. And luckily, the Reverend Father didn't die, but the principal of the school died. So it's tears. This few days have been heralded by a lot of pain. You know, people mourning their losses, people whose relatives didn't die had their houses, you know, also affected. We know that we had over 50 houses being affected in the cause of this. And right now, 5 days later, not much has been done, away from the governor saying, okay, we're going to set up a $2 billion fund aside, and then we have a few other corporates who have said, okay, we're going to be pledging $100 million each. But the point is, 5 days after, it's still tears.
All right, let me go to Dr. Hassan there. 468 people have been displaced, you know, as you can also hear Mary trying to expatiate on that, from their homes, and 100 and now, you know, moved to a place, according to the government officials. Now, we know that you're involved in this case, and you know a new angle. Could you share with us your revelation as part of the Justice Committee for Abule Ado?
Well, the 15th of March was a Black Sunday in Abule Ado, and the aftermath of that is still a tale of wolves, tears, and blood, and there is no sight of respite and relief at the moment to the inhabitants, especially the victims, not to mention those that were in the hospital just there. We don't know their state of medications and every other thing, but not to overbloat much. The entire inhabitant in that area is no less than 10,000. And within the specific area, there are big houses, and the displaced people at the moment is not less than 3,000. Those that died, we cannot ascertain, because the rubbles itself are just left the way it is. There is no detailed entry, there is no detailed rescue mission, there is no detailed approach. Everything around there is just like everybody watching, including, you know, the entire area itself is not condoned, because we believe that the tremor of the blast itself, there could still be an aftermath reaction scientifically, because the tremor and the magnitude of this blast went as far as over 500 to 1,000 kilometers away from that blast, and it shook houses at Gondo, at Ijegun, at Festac, not just houses within the precinct of that environment. So this is one of the reasons why we say we cannot work on assumption in a defined society that has planning. After 48 hours, we are here to get a detailed forensic analysis report, even if it is interim. Something by the texture of the soil, by going deeper to go to how much was the effect to the ground, how much have been destroyed to the ground. Because if that blast weight went underneath the ground and it shook most of those houses, that means the houses within that area can collapse maybe after 5 years from now. because the building texture are already failing. But quite to say, there is no resettlement, immediate relief resettlement center for every for the inhabitant. And as I speak, some of the residents are moving into those debris to live and get themselves above within that area. That's how unfortunate. So in as much as the state government has come up with the AMZAT-led inquiry committee for 2 weeks, we are informed that in our press conference on the 18th of March that that committee cannot work in Alausa. That committee needs to come to the precinct of that area to ascertain the forensic scientific expert report, to ascertain the number of houses that were damaged, the number of inhabitants, so that they can take inventory and evaluation report of that entire area. So these are critical assessments that need more collective approach in handling. So the community, the inhabitant, then where are the culprits that are involved in this crime? Have there not been information? Have there been arrests before?
I mean, when you say crime, we haven't even been able to establish what it is. Before you go on there, you know, you were talking about forensic experts.
Yes.
Is it a question of we not having the capacity, or is it a function of not having the willpower?
Is both lack of capacity and will. We are more on a verge of lip service, of doing the cosmetics and then just to do the euphoria. Let you know, announcement of the 2 billion to me is like we are not mourning the victim. We are just trying to arouse their fears and try to destabilize their hope, because with the announcement of the 2 billion, without proper injection of, oh, we need immediate funding for ABC. Mm-hmm. Now, even relief goods that were brought from Indomie to rice and some things, do you know that staffs of the NEMA and some other officials around are the ones that carted those things away? Why the victims?
Do we have evidence to that?
I mean, yes, because I met with the CDA leadership, one of the victims, and I was aghast to hear from how their fears are growing day by day, that the relief goods that were brought, that the NEMA officials, oh, they are going to take it away to their office before they come back, count the head, count those that are victims. I say, come, these are the victims that are here. It's just for you to call, oh, this is what we have, who are available. Even spectators, you know, Nigeria is strictly a poverty environment. Yes, we are capital property of the world, but that doesn't mean that the government should not pay immediate attention to where the need is required. Mm-hmm. So what we are trying to say here is that in as much as the pipeline is a federal government property, the area itself has been has had serial experience of pipeline vandalism and all that, especially from the Arekpo to the Barua to Jegun to that same corridor. But we cannot specifically say that something is not added to that pipeline because of the blast and magnitude. Even if it is ordinary pipeline explosion, the heat cannot go as far as 1,000 kilometers. So that is where we are now coming. That the National Security Advisor ought to bring in the DMI to reinvestigate the scientists to know, oh, what really happened? Mm-hmm. What is the aftermath effect? Is this area still endangered?
Right.
Do we still have a repeated? Because if this happened and we are just playing the politics of, oh, let us call a cheap card. No. We need the detailed analysis. Then the fund that was announced itself is not enough to meet up to those damages that was being wrecked in that area. So there is a need for government to have an holistic plan. Firstly, let them have a resettlement point that best feed the life of the people. At the resettlement point, we know this is a coronavirus era. They need to take higher precaution in dealing with the issue. So it's not just us just saying, oh, we have done something. The president is yet to come around, though the minister came on the 18th, the minister for natural disaster. But it's not enough for Mr. President to watch Abule Ado via photographs. Yes. We need his president. That is why it's Mr. President. And what caused that incident is federal government property. So the state government doing the preliminary support mechanism needed to be taken over by the federal government.
We have to wrap it, unfortunately. Thank you, Dr. Hassan, and thank you, Mary Chinda, for bringing us
thank
up to
speed.
Thank
you very much.